Welcome to another live streaming tutorial. In this video, I'm going to show you how you can go ahead and start streaming to Twitch using Streamlabs OBS. Let's go ahead and dive in. All right, so the very first thing that we want to go ahead and do is we want to go ahead and establish your internet speed. So I want you to go ahead and go to speedtest.net, and you can find the link in the description of this video along with any other links that I go ahead and mention. And we want to go ahead and test your internet speed. This is important because it's going to determine the kind of experience that your viewers are going to have when you're live. So once you're there, you're simply going to want to select go. And what this is going to do is that it's going to go ahead and figure out your ping. It's going to figure out your download speed, and it's also going to go ahead and figure out your upload speed. Now, the upload speed is the number that we want to focus on the most. And you want to go ahead and write this number down, or you want to go ahead and take a mental note of it, as we're going to need it later on when we're setting up Twitch inside of Streamlabs. So once you have that figure, we can go ahead and move on to Streamlabs. All right. So now that we're inside of Streamlabs, the very first thing that you want to do is you want to go ahead and hit the settings icon. This is going to go ahead and bring up a new window for you. And the very first thing that we want to do under general is that you want to scroll down to where it says output. I highly recommend that this is kind of like a pro tip to go ahead and select show confirmation dialog when starting and stopping stream. This prevents you from accidentally starting or stopping your stream without you knowing. So make sure you have that there. And then the next thing I want you to do is to come to the stream tab. This is where we're going to go ahead and integrate Twitch directly into Streamlabs. So streaming type, you're going to leave it under streaming services. Service, you're going to go ahead and select Twitch, and then you're going to go ahead and select server, select auto recommended, and then your stream key. So to be able to get your stream key, we're going to want to go ahead and jump over to Twitch. So let's go ahead and do that now. All right. So once you go ahead and get logged into your Twitch account, you're going to want to click on your profile icon, and then you're going to want to go to the creator dashboard. Once you're on the creator dashboard, what you want to do is you want to come to where it says settings. You want to hit that drop down. You want to go to where it says stream. And this is going to go ahead and say primary stream key. What you simply want to do is you want to hit copy. You're going to come back into Streamlabs, and you're going to go ahead and paste that stream key there. You're then going to go ahead and hit done, and that's going to go ahead and integrate your Twitch directly into Streamlabs. Now, what you want to do is you want to go back to settings, because now we want to improve the quality of your stream so your viewers have a good experience. So what you want to do is you want to come to where it says output, and here you're going to want to go ahead and select advanced under output mode. You're then going to go ahead and leave audio track as 1. Your encoder, you're going to leave it as X264. And then it's very important, especially if you're not a Twitch partner or a Twitch affiliate, and you're going to want to have like 1080p streams, you want to make sure that you uncheck where it says enforce streaming service encoder settings. Very important if you want the next step to be able to work. So then under rate control, you want to go ahead and put CBR. And then for the bit rate, this is where I told you to make a mental note or to write down your upload speed, because this is where it's going to turn whether you can put this bitrate that I have or you need to make a modification. So I recommend if you have more than 10 or, you know, higher than 7,750, that you go ahead and match what I have here. If you put this exact bitrate, it's going to allow you to stream to 1080p 60, even if you're not a Twitch partner or Twitch affiliate. But if you have a upload that's less than 5, then I would recommend putting this around 2,500, 2,300. That way you can still have a good experience. And then you want to do keyframe intervals at 2, CPU usage very fast, profile you want it at high, and then tune you want it at 0 latency. Then what I want you to do is that I want you to come to the audio tab, and I want you to make sure that on their mic auxiliary device 1, you go ahead and put the mic that you're going to be able to utilize. You'll see it pop up here on the bottom right in Streamlabs, let it know that it's connected. And then very important, I want you to come to video. This is going to be how your stream is going to look and how smooth it's going to run. So for the base canvas, I want you to do 1920 by 1080. The output, I want you to have it at 1920 by 1080. The downscale filter, I want to have bilinear, which is going to be the fastest, not going to create any kind of blurriness. And then as far as the FPS type, I want you to do common FPS values, and then a common FPS value, I want you to go ahead and put 60. Once you've gone ahead and done that, I want you to then come to where it says advanced, and where it says advanced, I want you to make sure you have process priority at normal. Then go ahead and hit done, and you're going to now be integrated directly with Twitch into Streamlabs. Now, if you're going to want to know how to add like a countdown timer, how to go ahead and add your gameplay and things of that sort, go ahead and watch this video right here where I show you how to go ahead and add scenes and sources and overlays to your Streamlabs stream. I'll see you in the next video.